The article begins, 37-year-old Brandy Martell was sitting behind the wheel of her car around 5:15 a.m. when one or two men walked up and began a conversation. My eyes can't help but wander to the photo provided as they filled with tears for what I know will be a very sad tale. The title is one that is all too common, yet all too rare. I remember the lack of coverage of a transgendered child brutally beaten by a raving lunatic, screaming Christian verses and hate-filled slurs against the child here in Seattle. The child survived, barely, but the story still weighs heavy in my mind. Homosexuals are treated as second-class citizens, but transgendered people are treated as no-class citizens, and this bothers me a lot. That we, as modern as we are, as scientifically and intellectually advanced as we are, still brush people under the carpet. We leave these people on the streets because no one will hire them for work. We let them suffer because doctors ignore their needs. We abuse and torment them, then turn a blind eye when they die. This is not how an evolved species behaves. This is how beasts infected with rabies behave. What are we to do? What can we do to make things better? We could stand up for even the smallest minority groups instead of shun them because they are different. It doesn't take much. Just a petition for the police or courts to do something. But take it one step further. Do not allow the bigot scum to forget their horrible deeds. Announce these stories to the world. Spread the news. Plaster the walls and websites with the faces of the dead and beaten people to remind the religious zealots of the hatred they are breeding in a culture that should be above such acts of violence. Transgendered people have a small voice since they are the smallest minority. So everyone else must add their voices to speak up. But most importantly, people in a minority class or group or race, add your voices together. The bigots are winning because even us minority groups are forgetting others. If the bigots can put aside their differences and rally under one banner, speaking up for even the lesser of their numbers, then why can we not do this? Shed a tear for Brandy and raise a glass to the forgotten people. Most importantly, raise your voice against all prejudice in the world. Shout from the rooftops that no one is safe or free until everyone, even the smallest of us, are safe and free. Tell the people in power that we are now united under one banner of freedom. The minorities of race, the minorities of lifestyle, the minorities of science, and the minorities of gender. Together we can be stronger than the majority. Together we can beat back the tide of bigotry. Shed a tear for Brandy and all the ignored dead. Tell everyone about every tragedy that the hatred has caused. For the simple fact that the majority do not care, we shall make the voices of the victims even louder than the ranting of evangelists.